In MCQ 20, we'll shift our focus towards excretion, particularly towards the hormone ADH, otherwise known as antidiuretic hormone. Now again, the summary here will be that antidiuretic hormone ADH is actually produced by the hypothalamus, and it is then stored inside the anterior pituitary gland. The anterior pituitary gland will release a suitable amount of ADH depending on the water potential of our blood plasma. So in the event, if let's say we're looking at a low blood plasma water potential, the amount of ADH released in this case here, it will be a large amount. And the main site that it will travel to will be the kidney nephrons, each of the individual functional cells of the kidney. And the main thing here is that it will actually increase the permeability of collecting duct, I will abbreviate this as CD, to water. And as a result, this will increase the amount of water via selective reabsorption. Now the end result here is that the quality of the urine will be low volume as well as concentrated. Now on the flip side here, if let's say we're looking at an increment in blood plasma water potential, the amount of ADH release will decrease. Again, the main site it's targeting to is towards the kidney nephron. And instead of increasing the permeability of collecting duct to water, it will decrease the permeability of collecting duct to water. The amount of water reabsorbed is much lesser, and this results in an increase in the volume of urine, and the urine quality is much more diluted. So in this situation here, the amount of water filtered into the nephron itself, as well as the amount of water that's reabsorbed, these are two totally different portions. The filtered portion here will be via the process of ultrafiltration, which is not affected by the concentration of ADH that's found inside the blood plasma. So ultrafiltration really just depends mainly on the pressure that's found at the renal artery, as well as the substance must be able to pass through the pores of the basement membrane to be captured in the Bowman capsule as your glomerular filtrate. So it will be unchanged regardless of the amount of ADH. Now reabsorption, definitely ADH plays a big impact based off this summary chart that's given on the right side of the screen. So we'll then say that the increase in the amount of ADH will actually be in the blue color scenario, because there's a decrease in blood plasma water potential, and therefore the amount of water reabsorbed after filtration will increase, and as always, it will result in a low volume of concentrated urine. The answer for MCQ 20 is